Hello guys, what's up? This is Sir EJ and welcome again to another math tutorial. In today's topic, we will be discussing the permutation of n objects taken r at a time. Let's have the following objectives in today's topic. At the end of the lesson, the students should be able to letter A, derive the formula to find the permutation of n objects taken r at a time, letter B, find the permutation of n objects taken r at a time, and letter C, value the concepts of permutation in solving real-life situations. Let's derive the formula of permutation using this example. How many possible ways can we arrange the following letter or letters? Number 1, letter A. Number 2, letter A and B. Number 3, letter A, B and C. Number 4, letter A, B, C and D. And number 5, letter A, B, C, D, and E. To derive the formula of permutations taken all at a time, we will use our knowledge about our previous topic. We will apply the fundamental counting principle. Let's have the first question. We have to get the following arrangement we can make with letter A. And then we have the number of permutations or the multiplication rule. So we have one object taken all at a time, therefore, we only have one permutation and its factorial version is equal to 1 factorial. Meaning to say, if we will simplify 1 factorial, that is equal to 1. Next, let's try to get the permutation of the two letters, letter A and B. So we have the size of the set, we have 2, and the elements of the set is letter A and letter B. The number of permutations, we have 2 objects taken all at a time. So on our first factor, we have 2 because we can select letter A or letter B. And then on our second factor, it will become 1 only because we have already selected one letter here. So this will be 2 times 1 and that is equal to 2. And the factorial version of 2 times 1 is 2 factorial. And then if the size of the set is equal to 3, the letters A, B, and C, obviously, the number of permutations using the multiplication rule or the fundamental counting principle will be 3 because there are 3 letters we can select. And then after we have select one letter here, we will multiply it by 2, meaning to say we can choose 2 letters. And then after that, the third factor will be 1 because we have already selected one letter here and one letter here. Therefore, this will be equal to 1. And then multiplying that 3 times 2 times 1 will be equal to 6. And the factorial version of 3 times 2 times 1 is equal to 3 factorial. And then let's have the size of the set. If it is equal to 4, the letters A, B, C, D. And then the number of permutations or multiplication rule will be 4. Then after that, times 3 times 2 times 1 equals 24. And its factorial version is equal to 4 factorial. And then if the size of the set is equal to 5, the letters A, B, C, D, E. On the first factor, we have 5 possible selections, the letters A, B, C, D, and E. After you have chosen one here, it will become 4. It will become 3, 2, and 1. And then multiplying this numbers, 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1 is equal to 120. And the factorial version of 120 or 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1 is equal to 5 factorial. We can generalize this rule by using the size of the set, which is equal to n or the number of objects, and then the number of permutations or multiplication rule will be the variable n times the quantity n minus 1 times the quantity n minus 2 times the quantity n minus 3, so on and so forth, then 4 times 3 times 2 times 1, which is equal to n factorial. Therefore, if we will try to solve the number of objects taken all at a time, we will use the formula n factorial. And the factorial notation, in other words, you will multiply the number n being operated upon by every positive integer smaller than n. Let's say, for example, 5 factorial. We will start with 5 times followed by the smaller number, which is 4, times 3 times 2 times 1. 4 factorial, 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. So that is the factorial notation. That is how we simplify or compute the factorial notation. So in our first example, we have derived the formula for the number of permutations of all objects taken all at a time, meaning to say all the objects will be used. How about if not all the objects will be used? So let's try to derive the formula for that one. See, how many possible ways can we arrange the 5 letters A, B, C, D, and E if we will only select 3 letters? So we will select 3 letters using the letters A, B, C, D, and E. So using the fundamental counting principle, on our first box, we have 5 possible selections, the letters A, B, C, D, and E. And then after we have chosen on the first box, on the second box, we have only 4 possible selection. And then on the third box, it will become only 3 possible selection or 3 possible ways. So 5 times 4 times 3 is equal to 60 possible ways. So therefore, there are 60 possible ways we can arrange the letters A, B, C, D, and E if we will just select 3 letters. Using this problem, let's try to derive the formula of permutation. So we have 5 times 4 times 3. This is our original solution, 5 times 4 times 3. What I did here is I just add the factors 2 and 1. I have multiplied it times 2 and times 1. And then I divide it by 2 times 1 to cancel out 2 times 1, both numerator and the denominator. After that, I have transformed this in factorial form. The factorial form of 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1 is equal to 5 factorial. And then the factorial form of 2 times 1 is 2 factorial. So it becomes 5 factorial over 2 factorial. And then after that, permutations will be equal to 5 factorial. The 5 here is the number of objects or n, which is A, B, C, D, and E, and that is equal to 5. And then what I did here is I expressed the number 2 as 5 minus 3, which is 5 minus 3 is just equal to 2. I made it 5 minus 3 because the value of 5 is equal to n, which is the letters A, B, C, D, and E. And then the value of 3 is already given, which is the value of R, the number of letters we will select. So that is the value of R. So 5 is equal to N, the 5 letters, and 3 is equal to the value of R. And then after that, if we have a set with N objects, the number of permutations of R objects of the set is equal to N factorial over the quantity N minus R factorial. Let's have our first example. Find the permutations of the numbers 1 to 8 if 4 numbers are taken at a time. Let us identify first the given. The number of objects or the value of n is equal to 8, and that is the 8 numbers, the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And then the value of r is equal to 4 because there are 4 numbers which is taken at a time. And then after that, we will use the formula of permutation. NPR is equal to n factorial over the quantity n minus r factorial. And then we have the permutation of 8 objects taken 4 at a time is equal to the value of n, which is equal to 8 factorial, over the quantity, the value of n again is equal to 8, minus the value of r is equal to 4 factorial. And then we have 8p4 equals, we will expand 8 factorial, that is 8 times 7 times 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1, all over 8 minus 4 is equal to 4 factorial. And then after that, we will just copy 8 times 7 times 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1, all over, we will expand 4 factorial, and that is equal to 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. And then we will cancel out 4 times 3 times 2 times 1, both on numerator and then the denominator. And then we have 8p4 is equal to 8 times 7 times 6 times 5. Multiplying these numbers, we will get the answer, which is equal to 1,680 possible ways. Therefore, there are 1,680 permutations of numbers 1 to 8 if we will just use 4 numbers. Let's have our second example. In how many ways can 9 students arrange themselves for a picture taking if they like to have only 4 of them will be in every shot? Let's identify first the given. So the value of n is equal to 9, which is the 9 students. And then the value of r is equal to 4, which is 4 of them will be in every shot. And then we will use the formula. The permutation of n objects taken r at a time is equal to n factorial over the quantity n minus r factorial. And then after that, we will substitute the corresponding value. So we have the permutation of 9 objects taken 4 at a time is equal to the value of n, which is equal to 9 factorial, over the quantity, the value of n, again, is equal to 9, minus the value of r is equal to 4, followed by factorial. And then we will bring down 9p4 equals, we will expand 9 factorial, and that is 9 times 8 times 7 times 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1, all over 9 minus 4 is equal to 5 factorial. And then after that, bring down 9p4 equals, copy 9 times 8 times 7 times 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1, all over, expand 5 factorial, that is 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. And then after that, we will cancel out 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1 on both numerator and then the denominator. And then we have 9p4 is equal to 9 times 8 times 7 times 6. Multiplying these numbers, we will get the answer, which is equal to 3024. Therefore, there are 3024 possible ways we can arrange 9 students for a picture taking if they like to have only 4 of them in every shot. Let's have our last example. In how many ways can we arrange 7 books if only 5 books will fit on a shelf? So let's identify the following given. So the number of objects, which is n, is equal to 7, that is 7 books. And then the value of r is equal to 5. 5 books will fit on a shelf. We will use the formula. The permutation of n objects taken r at a time is equal to n factorial over the quantity n minus r factorial. And then all we need to do is to substitute the corresponding value. So we have 7p5 equals the value of n, which is equal to 7 factorial, all over the quantity, the value of n again is equal to 7, minus the value of r is equal to 5 factorial. And then bring down 7p5 equals 7 factorial is 7 times 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1, over the quantity 7 minus 5 factorial is equal to 2 factorial. And then bring down 7p5 equals, copy 7 times 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1, all over, we will expand 2 factorial, that is 2 times 1. And then after that, we will cancel 2 times 1 on both numerator and then the denominator. And then we have 7p5 is equal to 7 times 6 times 5 times 4 times 3. And then multiplying this number, we will get the answer, which is equal to 2,520. Therefore, there are 2,520 possible ways we can arrange 7 books if only 5 books will fit on a shelf.